Hello all, welcome to Acadgild's Full Stack Web Development Program. In this video, I will walk you through the process of adding components to our application. A React application is all about dividing the user interface into simple and small components. These components are later composed together to form a complex user interface. At first, we should add Bootstrap to our application. Bootstrap is a popular HTML, CSS, and JavaScript framework for developing responsive web applications. It was originally created at Twitter. To add Bootstrap, we can use one of the following commands. Let me go to the command prompt. Make sure that you are in your application directory. We can use either yarn or npm command to add Bootstrap. Yarn add Bootstrap at the rate of 3.3.7. So this command is going to install Bootstrap library version 3.3.7 in our React application. After adding Bootstrap to our application, let us now start our application. We can make use of yarn start. I have already gone ahead and made a change to the application by adding a couple of components. I have given the name of the component as contact list and contact detail. Let us look into the project and walk through the code. The source code of the React application will generally be available inside the SRC folder. By default, every React application created using Create React App tool will have a root component. The name of that root component will be generally app. The app component. I have created a folder within the SRC directory. The name of the folder is contacts. This particular folder is being used to store all the components and code related to contacts within the application. I have created two components within this application. The first component is called as contact detail. The other component is called as contact list. The contact list component is used to display the list of contacts, and the contact detail component is used to display the information of an individual contact. Now let us look into the contact detail component. The contact detail component is a very simple functional component within React. So I have created it as a functional component. The contact object, which contains the contact information, is passed to this component as a prop. A prop in React is a parameter that is passed from the parent component. The contact information such as name, email, phone, and image is rendered by making use of JSX syntax. The user interface of a component is normally described using JSX. JSX is a syntax extension to JavaScript. It is similar to templating language that is used in other frameworks like Angular. So if you see the code over here, the code is basically a function which takes props as a parameter, and the function is describing the user interface for this component using the JSX syntax. Various information which is there within the contact object, such as name, phone, email, and image, they are being displayed inside the JSX code. And this entire JSX code is returned back. It is rendered. So that is the contact detail component. Let us look into the contact list component. Contact list component has been coded as a normal class-based component, which means it's a class that extends from React's component class. This particular component stores the list of contacts within the component's state. This list is stored as an array of contact objects. The contacts array is initialized within a component did mount lifecycle method of the component. Currently, this array is initialized locally within the component. In a later video, we will explore how to get this array from the server API. A class-based component in React should contain a render method. The render method is used to describe the UI of the component, of this particular component. Here, the render method is simply iterating through the list of contacts, that is the array of contacts. This array is available in the state, and the render method is generating the UI that is required to display the list of contacts. It uses the contact detail component that we saw earlier to display the individual contact information. JavaScript's array map method has been used to iterate through the array of contacts. Now, this contact list component has been referred within the app component. As you all know, app component is the root component of the application. It has been implemented as a class-based component. It displays the application header, and then it displays the list of contacts by using the contact list component that we saw earlier. Now, this root component, app component, has been referred inside the index.js, and it has been rendered by making use of react-dom.render method. Now, we added the Bootstrap library for this particular project. It has to be included within the code, and that code has been, we can see that the Bootstrap library has been included using an import statement within index.js. So the contact detail and all the other components that we have seen, they make use of Bootstrap's components in order to style the various HTML elements within the UI. With this, we have created the React components that are required for the application. The UI looks like this. So we see the header, which is Contact Manager app here. And currently, our application displays the contact information for two contacts. Thank you for watching this tutorial. In the next video, you will look into implementing contact list functionality.
Acadgild. Average is dead.